department along with the Panchayat Raj and Rural Development. Sri BVR Mohan Reddy Garu, Chairman, NASCOM, one of the pride of our Telugu people, Professor Karro Rati, Dr. Rishar Aruvarya, who has done a lot of research and work on this urban development. And then Mr. Vincento Gurat, Mr. Samir Sharma, Joint Secretary, who is looking after smart cities in my ministry, Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, Secretary, IT, Government of Telangana, Mr. Pratap Pododu, who is responsible for conceptualizing this idea, and then the man behind the show here. First of all, I would like to compliment Sri Tarak Ramarao and also Sri Pratap Padode for this conference and also the decision to organize it in Hyderabad, because Hyderabad is a place of happening and Hyderabad is a brand by itself. So today I am very happy to be admitted you to participate in this conference, where different ideas, experiences, success stories, challenges, problems, questions will be raised and addressed and discussed. This is a very useful forum that way. That's why when Tarak Ramarao has requested me, I readily agreed, because our government believes in working together. The center, state and urban local bodies, all of us has to work together, then only the country can progress. Country cannot progress without state progressing. State cannot progress without the urban local bodies progressing. This has to be understood by one and all. That's why our Honorable Prime Minister, the beloved leader, he said we must work as a team India. And we must also supplement each other's effort. Whatever great plans we may have, new ideas we may have, at the end of the day, unless the urban local body or the rural local body, Panchayat Raj institution, unless they are prepared, motivated, involved, you cannot achieve success. Ab Delhi ko, Delhi se Galli ko sudharna aasan nahi hai. Galli se Delhi tak aap ja sakte. Isliye, we believe in cooperative federalism of taking the states and also the urban local bodies together. That's the mandate given to us by our Honorable Prime Minister. I'm very happy today for this conference, because everybody has to learn. Even I came here to learn. I personally feel everybody has to learn throughout their life. Even politicians, they should learn more. Not earn more, but learn more. Learn, learn, learn. That should be the objective of every politician. Because you learn more, then it will be useful for you to implement it in a better manner. These isms have lost its relevance today, I can tell you. Once upon a time, people used to talk about capitalism, then communalism, then socialism, this ism and that ism. Now it is only realism. Realism, what is best suited to you, to your place, to your state, to the country, that is the ism. And that's people want development. People are becoming a little restive because they have seen after 68 years, still there are basic issues remain. World is moving faster. LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization, there is no way you can look back. So you have to catch up with the world. And there is no dearth of talent in India. Talent is very much available, resources also available to the possible extent. But we are not able to tap them properly, and we are not able to motivate the people properly. You see, today if you look at the international scenario, lot of our Indian people, they are heading. You see, Microsoft is led by a Telugu man, Satya Nadella. And then you have seen Google also the other day, Pichai from our neighboring state, Tamil Nadu. Then you have Indira Nui, PepsiCo head. You have Sakurthi Purna, who is heading the American Merrill Lynch Bank. I can give you a number of examples like this. There is no dearth of talent. But only thing is, we have to really once introspect what is lacking and then take forward the new ideas and new experience that has come worldwide. Thanks to internet, everything is available now. You can see what is happening in the United States, what is happening in Soviet Union, what is happening in Somalia. You can see it. and then plan according to your local needs. That's the need of the hour. Keeping that in mind, the Prime Minister has come out with this idea of smart cities. And then AMRUT, Atal Mission for Rural Urban Regeneration of Urban Transformation. And then you have Hrudaya, and then you have Swachh Bharat, then you have Housing for All. All these programs are aimed at uplifting the standards of life of the people in urban areas. The smart city is not for elitist people. Smart city is a concept that has to be followed by everybody. It's not 100 cities. The ultimate aim is that every city and every village in the country should become smart. That's the idea. It's only a beginning. 100 smart cities, only a beginning. That's not the end of the story. It's only a beginning. Once you are motivated and you see good examples, and then if you try to follow it, then you will also get an opportunity. The cities which are selected in the first instance, these 100 cities, they will also be going for a competition among themselves. The competition is such that there is no scope for anybody to have their personal preferences. Even the minister, I am Minister for Urban Development, Government of India. My city is not smart city, Nellore. Because there is no scope for any political decision. It's all decided on certain parameters. Certain standards have been fixed. The experience of different countries across the globe has been taken into consideration. Bloomberg, former mayor of New York, he came and also had consultation. And 15 countries have come forward to offer support, to extend the technological support in creating these smart cities, in also taking forward this AMRUT, new urban regeneration mission. So we'll be taking their experience. At the end of the day, you have to again take care of the local needs, local requirements, local climate, and also local aspirations. I have been to Barcelona. I saw Barcelona. Before I went, I thought Barcelona is only vertical everything. But once I landed there and I saw it, it's beautiful planning. They have kept the local architecture intact. So we also have to plan in such a way that nature, culture should be combined for a better future. Nature, culture for a better future. That should be there. Hyderabad should retain its culture, its heritage, its past. Warangal should retain its past, the Kakatiya Empire. Amaravati should retain its past. You may take lessons from different countries. Nothing wrong. Take ideas from Singapore or from Barcelona. But at the end of the day, we have to plan according to our local requirements. That's the first thing I would like to suggest. The second thing is this urbanization has become a reality. You can't go back now, even if you don't like. Even I have migrated from rural development to urban development. Now I'm urban development minister. Earlier I was rural development minister. My heart still lives in village, but I live here. So point is, because urban areas have become engines of growth. 60% of your GDP is coming from urban areas. And if you go with this speed, it may go up to 75% shortly. By 2030, 75% of the revenue will be coming from urban areas of the GDP. So that's the reality. So you have to take care. Why this urbanization? Not because of people don't like their village and they are coming to Hyderabad just for sake of fancy to see Taj Mahal, to see Charminar. No. Because urbanization has taken place because of education, employment, entertainment, economic opportunities, employment opportunities, enhanced medical facilities. These five E's are making people to move towards urban areas. But after coming here, people are realizing that life is not that colorful film which they were visualizing. Here it is becoming congestion, pollution. Then you have a lot of other problems, water shortage, then lack of transport. So we have to take care of all these aspects to make them livable. What is a smart city? Someone asked me. I said, smart city is a livable city, happily livable city. Simple definition if I have to give, it is a happily livable city. Nischinta hoke rahane ke liye. The smart city should be like that. So friends, some people are worried, sir, our city name is not there. Don't worry, these cities, they have to stand in competition. Some of them may get eliminated also. Simply qualifying for the test alone will not suffice. Some of them may be qualified, disqualified, and you may get an opportunity to get qualified also. So improve the living standards of our city by means of social infrastructure, by means of other facilities, and by means of revenue generation, by means of transparency, by means of accountability, by means of credit worthiness, you will get your chance. You will get your chance. This 500 Amrut also is almost going to be equivalent to smart cities. They will also be developed and they will be also receiving focused attention. Friends, the entire process will be completed by the end of this month. And from 1st of next month, September, the smart cities will be rolled out. 100 cities have been identified and they have been communicated also, and they will be joining the competition by the 1st of September. And the competition will go for 2-3 months, and at the end of the competition, the implementation part starts. So while implementing it, the winners of the first round, once they are announced, then the implementation of the smart city mission will be done by a SPV, special purpose vehicle, created for this purpose. The prime reason for creation of the SPV for smart city mission is to ensure operational independence and autonomy in decision making and mission implementation. We don't want to control from Delhi. We want to guide. We want to give hand holding. We don't want to control from Delhi. Even in the selection of the cities also is left to the states with certain parameters.